Hey everyone, here are 10 animated shows you should watch. Number 10, Hit Monkey. This one follows the story of a hitman monkey that is seeking revenge and is being mentored by the ghost of a dead assassin. This show had a very, very unique concept. Like, imagine a monkey that is an hitman being mentored by a ghost. That was something that immediately fascinated me. And the storytelling of it just works brilliantly. And this show is very short. It's bingeable. You can watch it finish like 1 hour. That's how bingeable it is. And it's very, very interesting. The storytelling is very exciting. The animation style is very unique. The fight sequences, the action sequences, they are very engaging. And with the animation style, it just works brilliantly. And because the show is a very short show, it is very, very easy to watch and it's very, very enjoyable. I'm sure if you watch It Monkey, you are going to love it. Number 9. Harley Quinn. This one follows the story of Harley Quinn, Joker's girlfriend, as she decides to end her relationship with Joker and to go off on her own and start her own thing. And I like what they did with this story, turning a villain sidekick into like an anti-hero type. And it was just very, very interesting to watch. And the characters in this show are very, very complex, layered characters. Characters that are so fun to watch. Characters that are complex and make decisions that are very fascinating to watch. And it's just something that works brilliantly. And this show has some dark humor that just works brilliantly with it. And the storytelling, the characters, everything that comes together to work with this show just works brilliantly. Harley Quinn is a fantastic show. Number 8, The Boys presents Diabolical. This one is the animated spin-off show of The Boys. And this one expands on the world of The Boys, focusing on different characters each episode. Like, in every episode, there is a different story. And because there is a different story, there are different animation styles. And because of that, it makes the show very, very interesting and very, very unique and very different. Like, every episode, you know you are getting a different story and you are getting different kind of animations. And it just keeps the show fresh and interesting. And this show is very, very brutal. Like, it is extremely brutal. Like, The Boys, like, you know The Boys is a brutal show. This show does not let down on that. It's also a very, very brutal show and it works brilliantly. And in this show, you get to see some of the origins of some characters in The Boys and how they became who they are. And this show just works very well to add backstory to some characters that we've seen already in The Boys. If you've not seen The Boys Presents Diabolical and you're a fan of The Boys, check this show out. I'm sure you're going to love it. Number 7, Love, Death and Robots. This show focuses on telling different stories each episode. Like, different stories that you're not even expecting, with different unique animation styles. Animation styles that you've probably not seen before. I know I saw some animation styles in this film that I have never ever seen before. And it was so engaging and it just made me connect more with the stories. And the fact that they always tell different stories each episode with different animation styles just makes the show very, very exciting and very interesting. You're always eager to see what comes next because you are going to be getting a different story with different animation and it just makes the show feel so exciting and fresh and unique. If you've not seen Love, Death and Robots, my guy, give it a chance. I'm sure you're going to love it. Number 6, Family Guy. This one follows the story of a family in a town. That's what I'll just say about the plot. And this show is very, very hilarious, very, very funny. Every time I watch this show, I'm always laughing so loud because it is very, very hilarious. There's something I love so much about this show. They always incorporate the use of pop culture references to tell their stories and it just makes it very, very fun. Like when you watch this show and you see them parodying a movie or a show that you've watched before and just making a joke of it, it's just something that makes it so hilarious to watch. And they do it so well. This show is very, very funny. And the characters in this show are very, very interesting characters. The characters, the main characters and the side characters, all of them are very, very interesting characters to watch. And I'm sure if you watch Family Guy, you are definitely going to enjoy it because you laugh so loud and you see some things that just take you back to some other shows or TV shows that you've watched that just makes the show feel so much better and feel like it's a part of the world. Number 5, Big Mouth. This one follows the stories of some high school students that are going through puberty. And that concept was something that I didn't think that I was going to enjoy. But when I watched this show, I was really, really amazed by how good it was. This show is very, very honest with its portrayal of what adolescents go through. And it was something that really, really intrigued me. Because I could relate to some of the things that this character went through. Because I myself have gone through some of these things that they've gone through. Like, I'm sure everyone has at some point. And it was just something that made this show very fun. And the way it's just portrayed was something that was done very, very honestly. And sometimes it's very, very educational. Like, I didn't think I could learn something from this show and relate to it as well. But I really did, and I could relate with it so much. And it was something that just made me appreciate this show so much. If you've not seen Big Mouth, give it a chance. And I'm sure you're going to love it so much, and you're going to laugh so much. Because this show is very, very hilarious. Number 4, Invincible. This one follows the story of a young boy that is becoming a superhero. And the storytelling of this show was something that was done very, very well. Like, in the first episode, they do something with it that just makes you realize the kind of show that you are in. and it just works very well. This show is very, very brutal. Sometimes it is hilarious, and it also deals with some dark themes. Like, if you watch this show, it's going to move you sometimes, and it's going to break you sometimes. But man, this show is a fantastic show. And the way it is gory and brutal is something that just adds to the overall brilliance of this show. And there's a particular scene in this show that went viral some time ago. If you've seen that scene, you'll understand what I'm talking about, and you know why this show works so well. Like, this show honestly was so much better than I expected. And if you've not seen Invincible, give it a chance. I am 1000% sure you are going to love it. Number 3, Rick and Morty. This one follows the story of a grandfather and his grandson as they go on different adventures on different universes. And this was something that I really, really enjoyed, because in every episode, they're always going on different adventures in different universes, and you're always seeing different kind of things that you're not even expecting. Like, the people that created this show, they were very, very creative with it, and they do some things that are just mind-blowing. And you'd be like, who comes up with this shit? But this show is very hilarious, and it works so well. And this show also makes use of pop culture references like Family Guy, and those pop culture references just works with it. And when you see those references and you can tell which show they are referencing, it just adds to the brilliance of the film and just makes you enjoy it more. And the characters in this show, they are very complex and interesting characters. You won't think that characters in a show like this will be complex and interesting characters, but they are. They are complex, they are interesting, and they are very, very engaging. And when you watch Rick and Morty, I'm sure you're going to love it. Number 2, BoJack Horseman. Of all the shows on this list, this one is my favorite. And this one follows the story of an us-like man that is a self-loathing alcoholic. Before I started watching this show, I didn't think I was going to enjoy it as much, because this show focuses on animals that are like humans. And I was thinking this show is going to be very, very ridiculous. But man, I was so, so wrong. And the way they go about telling the story of this man and the other characters in this show just works so well. You see all these characters dealing with some really, really complex emotions, and just makes the show very, very engaging to watch. Sometimes this show is very, very hard to watch, because it's going to give you some gut punches. Because you will see some characters doing something that just breaks your heart, and it just gives you gut punch after gut punch. You'll cry sometimes watching this show, and you'll laugh sometimes. But one thing that is sure is they are definitely going to enjoy this show. Number 1, Avatar, The Last Airbender. Of all the shows on this list, I'm sure this one is the most popular one, because I'm sure a lot of people have seen Avatar The Last Airbender. But that doesn't take away anything from the brilliance of the show. This show works so well. The characters in this show are very, very interesting, funny characters. Characters that you love to watch and engage. And they are interesting characters. Characters like Toph, Sokka, Aang, Katara, Zuko. All those characters are very, very interesting characters. And it just makes the show feel so good. And the fact that this show focuses on like a world, like a world with firebenders, earthbenders, airbenders, waterbenders. It makes it feel like a real world, and it makes it feel like this is a world that can really, really exist. It may be some part of the universe, and it just makes it very, very relatable and very, very exciting to watch. And the storytelling of this show was something that was done very well. This show started from season 1 and ends at season 3, and every season was just very, very interesting to watch. No season feels like it is dragging or it does something that it's not supposed to do. Everything just works. I feel like the showrunners of this show, they knew exactly what they wanted to achieve with the show, and they achieved it brilliantly. Avatar The Last Airbender was one fantastic show. The show even spawned a spin-off, Avatar The Legend of Korra. The Legend of Korra might not be as great as Avatar The Last Airbender, but The Legend of Korra is also a very, very interesting show. And that whole franchise, the Avatar franchise, just works brilliantly. If you've not seen Avatar at this point, my guy, yeah, go watch him. Go watch him, maybe come back and thank me. So those are 10 animated shows you should watch. What other shows do you think should have been on this list? Comment below and let me know. If this is your first time on my channel, please subscribe to my channel for more contents like this. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Cheers.